High gas prices lead to rising food prices and utility bills, but the trickle-down effect touches upon almost every U.S. industry, leading to higher costs for just about everything. Now add in a real estate slump, and you are finding South Floridians cutting back and in some cases drastically changing their lifestyles. Joining me to discuss surviving the squeeze, Jessica Sassier, president of the Consumer Credit Counseling Service of Palm Beach County and the Treasure Coast, Rick Christie, Assistant Managing Editor for the Palm Beach Post, and John Sanger, Vice President of Palm Beach Financial. Welcome all. Rick, let me start with you. People have had to meet issues of surviving mortgage real estate slump, food prices going up, as well as gas. How are they coping?
Well, people are just finding different ways to trim anything they can out of their monthly budgets. As you said, it started with our housing slump, and then it went to rising food prices, then now gas, and then maybe coming up increases in our utility bills. And so people are just doing all kinds of things. They're maybe taking public transportation more. They're buying more generic food at the grocery store rather than going for the name brands. They're cutting back on maybe their kids' piano lessons or delaying that piano tune-up that they needed. But everything that they can possibly do, they're thinking of. And that's one of the things that people are going to be talking about a lot more.
Jessica, why are we caught unawares? This is cyclical. There are a lot of naysayers, so there were a lot of people who were warning about this coming up and that there were going to be, certainly in government, budget shortfalls. We act so surprised. Is it because we're reluctant to face the truth?
Well, I will tell you, Helen, that I've been doing this type of work, helping people in financial trouble, for 21 years, and I have never seen anything quite like this. So if people are unaware, it's not really a surprise, because this is a pretty drastic time, and drastic times call for drastic measures. Hate to sound cliche, but that's the way it is. And I think some people are a little surprised at how quickly the gas prices went up. I think if you had told people, you know, last summer that gas was going to be close to $5 a gallon this summer, they probably would have said, no, no way. So I think that's really part of it, is part of it's real. It happened really quickly.
And of course, Jim, part of it is a big part, as we talked about it, you know, was ushered in by the mortgage crisis. And it's a very different type of mortgage crisis than we've seen before.
Well, it really is, because we're faced with a number of situations that we've never really seen before. I mean, if you want to look at the mortgage business and the real estate business, a lot of the underwriting models previously were always based upon an appreciating market. Well, as real estate stopped appreciating, and now that we've seen here in South Florida, in many respects, it's declined a lot, it's put people into the position where, from an underwriting aspect, it's very difficult to try to gauge how well that individual is going to pay. Because if the value of their home has now declined, in many respects, some of them are just up and walking out. And what we're seeing is that it continues to drive home prices down. Home prices in many parts of South Florida have fallen anywhere from 30 to, in some cases, 50%, depending upon the neighborhood. And with that, it puts a lot of stress on a lot of families.
It could actually be a good time to buy.
It's an outstanding time to buy.
It's a great time to buy. And at the same
time, the money and the good credit, yes.
Security.
Yeah.
Isn't
yes.
job security also a big issue?
Well, I think so. Well, certainly it is. The other thing is, I wanted to get to follow up with from what Jim said, is that is the wealth factor and the way people feel. A lot of the security that people had, the secure feeling that people had financially over the last 5 years, had a lot to do with their homes and the appreciation that we saw. All of a sudden, you bought a house for $150,000, and now within 3 years, it's worth $500,000, and you feel better.
Sure.
You feel more secure financially, and you start making decisions, in many cases, that you shouldn't make in terms of purchases. Now, a lot of those extras that we enjoyed, going out and buying that boat and servicing that boat, maybe even doing not cleaning your own pool anymore. A lot of those things are having to be changed now. And but it also has an effect on the psyche when all of a sudden now you're under the stress of having to make that bill payment every month, as well as now wondering whether or not, because your company isn't making as much money as it was making before, whether or not you will have that job
security.
Of course,
companies are finding it very difficult to be able to pass their increased costs onto consumers.
Sure.
Who are unable to pay. Restaurants are one example.
Absolutely. During a time when people feel a financial crunch, we feel, you know, as entrepreneurs and people in business don't want to go over the edge in terms of that, thinking people will go, won't come there anymore, or not actually incur that expense at all. And Rick pointed out, people are just not doing what I would consider to be luxury items, lawn maintenance, domestic help at home, women getting their nails done or men getting their nails done, having your hair done, depending on how often. I know, mine too.
I know, I'm covering up here.
I'm going by that.
Yeah.
I'm living by what I speak or what I teach, but that's just the way it is. I mean, and that hurts everybody, because those folks that were cleaning pools and, you know, cleaning homes and those kinds of things are hurt financially
but
by a lack of business.
Weren't we also living too much on credit? Weren't we also living in a bubble where we didn't feel like there was enormous responsibility? I saw an article a couple of weeks ago in the Wall Street Journal when they were talking about truck and car sales of U.S. major U.S. automakers. And they were saying that in 2006, a high percentage were bought with home equity loans.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's right. Astounding. And if it was a necessity, one would imagine, right. Well, that's a justification. But one has to wonder how much of this is a necessity.
Well, a lot of it is all based upon credit. I mean, if you have an easy flow of credit and it's available to people, and if somebody has to make a decision as to whether or not they want to spend current assets that they have or go out and finance it, many people just choose to take the path of going out and financing it. The problem is, though, is that now as we find that a lot of the assets that we had that the loans were based on have fallen in value, people, it's not difficult to make a payment on something if you know that it's worth $300,000 today, but it's going to be worth $400,000 tomorrow, and if you're stretching for that. But if the flip side is, now you're making a payment on something that's gone from 300 to 2.25, well, now it's an aggravation. And people have difficulty trying to just to change their thought process. But as we look at, you know, where are the areas where we're seeing an impact in terms of home prices that are falling, if you look at overall, what you typically like to see in terms of affordability is that home prices not exceed 3 times that of median income. Well, what we've seen in many respects over the course of the last several years is that in our area, sometimes home prices got up in excess of 7 times
That's right.
of what median incomes were.
Unfortunately, we've only got a couple of minutes left. What can a consumer do? What can a consumer look toward, and what can a consumer do to ride this wave, Jessica?
Well, it's going to sound pretty simple, but they're going to have to cut back on all of their expenses anywhere they possibly can. And obviously, if they're trying to keep their mortgage or their home intact, that can't be one of them unless they have the option of refinancing. And those are things definitely to look at before you get behind taking a look at those items. But absolutely living and sticking to a budget. And that goes back to, you know, not going to the movies as often as you may like to, cutting out all luxury expenses that you have, taking your lunch to work every day, maybe even looking at cutting back on savings. I never really like to suggest that, but if we're talking about whether or not you can keep a roof over your head and food in your, you know, in your family's mouths, then you need to take a look at all of those items. Where I work, we provide that type of help to work on budgets for people at Consumer Credit Counseling Service. So can't do it on your own, come and get some help.
And of course, Rick, you know, just very quickly, what can people do, for example, rising food prices? I mean, is that all gas related too, or?
Well, some of it is. I mean, the cost of delivery of all those foods, of course, has been impacted a lot by the gas prices. Excuse me, the increase in gas prices. But in terms of food prices, a lot of it is regulated. Again, if you're buying generic brands of foods, of course, that's one way to lower it. Don't eat out as much as you used to. You know, that helps. I got to tell you, don't eat out as much as you used to. But one of the things I wanted to suggest for people is that they take advantage of the information that's out there to help them with this. As Jessica was saying, her organization is available for that kind of thing. And even and Jim was speaking earlier about a lot of people who are in foreclosure or near or pending foreclosure. More than 50% of them aren't even talking to anyone or talking to their bank about right. helping them through this. People have to take advantage of this information that's available to them.
Of course, it's always better to speak to your creditor than to try to run away from
Absolutely.
Your creditor.
Absolutely. Yes. We all agree on that.
And we're out of time. We're going to have to talk about this again. Thanks to Jessica Cecere, Rick Christie, and Jim Sanger for joining us. Remember, for more information on the topics discussed on this show, just log on to palmbeachpost.com. And beginning Sunday, the Palm Beach Post and palmbeachpost.com begin coverage about the local impact of today's economic hardships. In the coming weeks, look for stories about your neighbors and local businesses. Last week, we featured a segment on the Democratic National Committee's decision to seat Florida delegates at the party's convention in August. A viewer writes, "I, along with friends and family, feel disenfranchised and very disillusioned with the political process. As one of your commentators stated, we think back to the vote in 2000, and now, once again, my vote counts for half the value." Remember, we encourage you to share your thoughts. Please email us at issues@channel2.org and give us your comments on today's program. And don't forget to tune in to another edition of Issues next Friday night at 7:30 p.m. right here on Channel 2. For more information about our program, visit our website at channel2.org/issues. I'm Helen Foray. Thanks for watching.